We are back here on Smells Like 90s Rock. And no, okay, so you were just disgusting.
Disgusting, basically.
Yeah, you were. I mean, okay.
We were talking about teeth.
Explain again your oral surgery. What was it again that you had?
Oh, I had gum surgery to basically like add gum to my gums.
And how did they do it?
They gave, this was like in the late 80s, early 90s. No, early 90s. So I was in third grade.
Mm-hmm.
They gave
I
me
was
an
three,
injection.
Like baby. Somewhere in the world, so there's some third grader getting her teeth taken out. We're going to get to go to college together.
Yeah.
Yay.
Thank God I'm a slacker. I didn't get around to like adulthood to, you know, you got there.
That's right.
Yay.
They just gave me anesthesia local shot in the roof of my mouth and my bottom gums, and then they scraped the tissue off the top of my mouth and sewed it onto my gums.
So essentially you have roof of your mouth as your gums. Mutant. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, basically, yeah.
Okay, so it's essentially like, what is it when they take a part of your butt cheek and they put it and they replace it? What surgery is that? There's some surgery.
Tommy John surgery, I think.
Tommy John? What? Explain.
That's like the arm surgery, though.
That's right.
Think they take like a tendon from your leg and put it in your arm.
That's right. You need some sort of part of your body.
Yeah, like
in
if you get burns
area.
And then mm-hmm. they basically take
that's
skin
right.
off your
you got
butt.
A gum graft.
Butt skin and they replace it on the burn. Yeah.
Yeah, it's basically
or
what
if
I
you
have
need hair on your head, they take your butt hair and put it on your head.
Yeah.
Hair they actually transplant. Do that.
Yes.
Yeah, but literally they'll take hair from other parts of your body and put it on your head.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds like desperation.
It really is.
Like, can you just put hair from my ass on top of my head?
At that point, I would just say,
I'm
you know what?
Self-conscious.
I'll be bald. I'm not that, because you don't know what that hair has been through in the last 26 years.
I mean, well, actually, I would say the hair on your butt would be cleaner for most people than the hair on their heads.
I don't know about that.
Sits in your underwear all day. Like, if you know how to efficiently wipe your butt, you should be okay. Like, if you have learned that skill,
that's true.
I think you'll be okay.
That's true. Okay. Yeah, I'll give you
like,
that.
But imagine, like, what your head of your hair walks through.
It's like the dog's mouth cleaner than the human mouth theory. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm going to go with butt hair's cleaner than head hair. I'm going with it. I'm making my claim. Butt hair's cleaner.
Okay.
Assuming that you fully are aware of how to wipe
we
it.
We have been back literally 2 minutes, and we have talked about
ass hair,
your the mouth, the roof of your mouth getting scraped with tissue samples. I mean, it's just
sewn on. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Let's talk about bleeding gums too. That's
this
fun.
Show, bleeding gums. Yeah, that's a classic hit. Hit us with that one.
I don't have bleeding gums.
I do.
Don't get it when you brush.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't go to the dentist till I was 13. We were talking about this earlier,
mm-hmm.
and I had no cavities somehow. But like my second trip to the dentist, I obviously hadn't listened to them about flossing or brushing because my gum, there was blood on that little apron thing that they put on you.
Yeah.
There was quite a bit of it, and they were just sort of like condescendingly looking down at me, like. Like, you suck, dude.
Yeah.
Your gum suck.
Yeah, I've gone since I was 5 years old, I've gone every 6 months, and
That was a terrible innuendo you guys missed out on. You and your gums suck.
Suck.
No.
I don't get it.
No one's gonna take that one.
No,
I don't get it.
No, I give you a
suck.
I give you a zero on
sucking.
That one.
Sucking.
Stop saying sucking. It's making it. It's not making it better.
It's not making me get the connection. No. My brain's too tired.
Oral sex, Sheila. Oral sex.
Wow.
Well, yeah, but how? Just the word "suck" doesn't necessarily always lead there.
No, there's also lick. What am we doing?
Fine. Am I 12? Is that what this is about?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Exactly.
What are we doing?
Okay, you were saying, Todd.
I don't even remember. We went off on a tangent. No. Every 6 months, I've gone to the dentist. But you know what? I still don't floss, and I get the beating gums. You know what I'm saying. And when they do that, and they do the scraping, I hate the scraping. And then, and then I look down at the apron, and it looks like, you know, a Wes Craven, rest in peace movie. It looks awful. There's plaque and blood everywhere. Because I don't floss. But I brush every day.
You
so
all
it's okay.
are talking about like my horror, like you're talking about like my Freddy Krueger or something. The
mm-hmm.
dentist. I
the
think
dentist.
We should change subjects, please.
No.
If I'm to sleep tonight, we need to change subjects.
I mean, the little you know,
Wes Craven should have made it like a killer dentist movie.
He should.
Just so he could show it to Sheila.
And it wasn't, and it's not even a horror movie. It's like just like a security.
It's just a documentary.
It's a security camera of just a regular dental visit, and that's it. That's the whole film. It was just somebody sitting in the chair getting the, you know, the scraping, and then the teeth brushing and the flossing.
Okay,
and,
stop, guys.
And then the lecture of you need to floss more.
Why
credits.
Do you insist on torturing
Roll
me?
Roll credits. That's the entire film. Bingo.
All right, no more dentist.
And that's
stuff.
A whole, and that's horrible, and that's horrific for you. You, you
music, it, hearing it just makes me want to.
You
gag.
Can't deal with the dentist.
No.
You can't deal with the
no.
dentist.
I was tortured as a child.
Well, you did live in Germany at one point, so that makes sense.
Yeah, I feel like tortured. A German dentist would be much more gung ho about.
Oh
you
God,
know.
Did you ever go to a German dentist?
No.
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 Oh God, could you imagine? No. That's frightening. Them yelling at you, and they're not even yelling at you, and you're in the chair.
You know, the only I went to a German doctor one time when I burned my hand,
mm-hmm.
and they were seriously way nicer than any American doctor I've ever been to. And what was weird is I went to the emergency room, and I waited 15 minutes before the doctor saw me.
That's brilliant.
And they have universal health care, so I'm just throwing
That's
that
wonderful.
Out
That's wonderful. That's nice.
Yeah,
nice.
I was like 15 minutes.
Why can't America be more like Germany? Not Germany like 70 years ago.
Yes,
that was bad
Germany.
Not the little mustache guy Germany. No, the years after.
But like New Germany.
New Germany. Yeah.
So Tila Tequila got kicked off of Big Brother because she's like, she was a Hitler supporter.
Was she?
She posted all this stuff out because she's crazy.
I didn't know that.
And then they found this out, and they're like, we can't have pro Hitler people in the house.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sorry.
Generally, we don't like that.
Yeah, like, you know, because it's filmed in Britain, and it's like, that's still kind of touchy.
Yeah.
And so she comes back, and she's like, I was just on a lot of drugs at that time. I don't really like Hitler. It's like, yeah, but you have pictures of yourself with a swastika on your arm. Like, you just got to suck it up. Like,
didn't know she was a Nazi. Didn't
she is.
Wow.
So Tila Tequila, who first of all would have been killed.
Mm-hmm.
For her behaviors.
Just her. Yeah. You know, exactly.
She's not exactly Aryan.
Mm-mm.
Was pro-Hitler and then, like, got kicked out.
However,
like,
Kim Davis would have been vice chancellor.
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. There you go.
That's the way it works. But, yeah, it's still real sensitive over there. Germany still believes they were on vacation between 39 and 45, so they don't talk about
that.
They don't talk about that era. Mm-mm, not happening.
Don't talk about what?
Nazi.
No, they still talk about
Hitler
it.
Hitler years.
They have to own it, so.
Yeah, well... We have to own Kim Davis, too.
We have to own things.
It's unfortunate.